They were known as Jono and Dano, and for more than 40 years, Jono Coleman and Ian Rogerson dominated airwaves right across the globe.
They were best mates, partners in crime, and the ultimate double act. And Dano joins us now. Dano, good morning. First
of all,
how are you doing, buddy?
Look, it's been such a strange weekend. You know, incredibly sad, but at the same time, you know, I constantly laugh and smile about the things I keep thinking about and the things people mention online and the lovely words from overseas and the sort of celebration of his life like this that's going on. I think that's really sort of, you know, comforting, and you realise how much that man packed into 65 years and what a guy he was.
How did you and Jono first meet?
Well, it was at the ABC at the very early Triple J days, and Marius Webb, who'd put together Double J and Triple J, brought him into the office and said, I want you to panel for this guy on Saturday night. We're going to give him a bit of a run and see how he goes. And so I did, and after about 10 minutes of him talking, I had to jump in, and I ended up working with him pretty well ever since.
Jono would always joke that way before Hamish and Andy, there was Jono and Dano. What was that like, and how crazy was that time? Because you guys were everywhere, not just on radio, you're on TV shows, there was merch.
I think we'd do a show whenever the fridge door was open, really, to tell you the truth. You know, it was one of those things, and we were just a couple of hams, enough ham to make a sandwich, we always used to say. And we were having so much fun because we were both, you know, 20-year-old knuckleheads and allowed to be paid and being professional idiots. And also the creativity that was there, we'd sort of run into the studio and try and think of things and then put them down, do the audio that goes with it. And, you know, we also worked with some fantastic people in the early days, and it just grew and grew and grew. And we just surfed that, really, and really enjoyed it. And we were just real good mates.
What are some of your best memories with Jono, if you can pick out a few? I imagine there are bucket loads.
Well, there are a bucket load. I mean, you know, I keep thinking this. There was we actually tried to swim from Sydney to Auckland on a cruise ship, which went horribly wrong because we hit really bad seas, and the swimming pool on the boat was like a washing machine, and like you'd see little kitties thrown out of the pool and in the middle of the air. So we were trying to save them. You know, we stopped traffic in Sydney all the way down Parramatta Road when we did a billboard broadcast for Triple M, and the police were trying to tell us to stop broadcasting, but they had to get in the cherry picker to come up to see us. So, you know, so many fantastic moments. You know, we interviewed so many great people, Will Ferrell, you know, you name it. And also, I think the other thing, the really important thing about Jono, and this shows you, I think, what he really was, some of the great moments I remember with Jono is sitting there having a meal with everybody around, the whole family, all of us together, all of our families, just having fun. And that they're the things I keep thinking of a lot over this weekend. You know, they're the things that you know, make me think they were the great times.
We feel like we know you so intimately because Jono and I shared a desk. Well, actually, I just sat at the desk that Jono claimed as his own and we'd hear all of these stories. You must tell us the story because he's been using this as long as I've known him. I've just got to go to that thing with George Danikian. What's that story about? Yeah. He said that was his get-out-of-jail-free
card. Of course, everybody loves George Danikian.
Everyone loves
but
George
But it was always a... but the Ricardo Montalban of Australia, actually, if I could say that much. But the thing about it was that what we used to do is, you know, invariably you'd find yourself in situations where you needed to get out of there, you know. And so our safety word, so to speak, was, oh, remember, we've got that interview with George Danikian coming up. That everybody and the whole crew knew. Everybody go, oh, right, OK, yeah, the George Danikian. OK, we better go. Better get out of here. See you later. So it was That was a secret word, but I feel like I'd share that with you now.
Oh, gee.
So actually, funny. Everybody can try it at home.
Yeah, I've got that,
when
George.
When you want to get out of a situation, just go, George Zanikian.
He used that excuse at my wedding. I've got to go. I've got the George Zanikian thing I've got to get
no.
to.
Dano, you've often said that you and Jono would look at each other after you'd done a gig, a live gig, a TV gig, a radio gig, and say to each other, did we get away with it? Did you?
Yeah. No, look, I got to say, we didn't have a bad hit rate. Probably better, sadly, than England did this morning. But I think what it was that we were... we would go into it with no script 99.9% of the time. Even if there was a rundown and even if there was a script, as you do in TV sometimes, you'd never end up following it. You know, you work with Johnny. It was like working with somebody with a mosquito brain. It's the way, if you saw something shiny, he'd be off into it. You know, but that was actually led to the fun. So I found a lot of the time, really, with the working that we do together, we'd have a lot of laughs, but also it was damage control. So you go, OK, how are we going to get out of this? And most of the time we did, you know. There was a couple of spectacular times we didn't. We ended up getting fired a number of the times. But, you know, hey, that's the biz.
Oh, Dano, thank you so much for all the laughs. You and Jono were just brilliant together. And, yeah, we're so sad that you've lost your mate too. It's a hard day. But thank you for sharing some memories of beautiful Jono.
I think the thing about it is, and it's really made me think all this weekend, is every time I think of him, I'll smile, and I think that's the truth. He just made me laugh.
Certainly did. We know you've got that thing with George Zanikian, so we better let you go.
I've got that important me. See ya.
Bye, Dano.